Hey guys and girls, welcome back to another edition of Let's Beat the Snot Out Of, and this time we have a shootout series. That's right, we are going to be shooting out the top three Land Rover based mods. The top three Land Rover based mods in Spinites. So what we're going to do is we're going to go and get the Mojave Green map, actually. And we're going to change a few things. First things we're going to change is we're going to use one of Fees's Land Rover discoveries, but we're not going to use the orange one. We're looking for the silver one, which I actually quite like. If I can find it. Find it. Yeah, yes, there is a lot of Land Rover mods, but I'm only going to do the top three that I like. So first things first, we're bringing in Hazard's Range Rover Classic. The next one on the hit list, if I can actually find it, is... I'm looking for it. This is bad when you've got this many mods and you can't find the one you're looking for. Spunning Darkness's Land Rover Defender 110. And, as I said, I've got to find that... there it is. Fees's Land Rover Discovery 3. So we're going to take them onto the Mojave Green course, and we're going to take them around the short course track on Mojave Green, which will test the living crap clean out of them. So let's get ready to rumble. So this basically covers all our basics of the Range Rovers that we've got available to us. Now we are going to be testing them fully spec'd. So for Hazard's Range Rover, we're going for the military spec tire, which looks a little odd, but it's military spec, so it should have more grip. For Spinning Darkness's Camel Trophy Range Rover, we will be adding the gear to the roof. And for the Discovery 3, we are going to be jacking this bad boy up with roof rack, toolbox, jerry cans, and 38s. Alrighty, so let's start with Hazard's Range Rover first. Okay. As expected, loud V8 rumble. So what we might do is just dial that volume back there. And let's go. Right, first of all, this will be the first one up on our short course track. Rules of the short course track shootout is damage done to the vehicle whilst on the short course. And of course, the furthest it can go, the better it is. Okay, so let's go fuel it up first, and then we'll get immediately into the course. Ooh, that sunk pretty far. Okay, good news is it got straight out of the fuel station, so that's a good thing. Alrighty, so what we're looking for now is we're looking for damage. We're looking for furthest distance, pretty much. So into the short course we go. First thing is a nice big water hazard, which will test the vehicle's ability to wade in deep water. It's not doing too good, to tell you the truth. Although we haven't got any damage, it feels like these tyres aren't really gripping themselves. Oh no, now we're moving. Oh, strange. We were moving for a minute there, and then it stopped again. Okay, let's see how we go. And we're climbing up and out of the short course. So this test basically tests the vehicle on how good it is as a trail vehicle. Handling rough inclines, steep inclines, mud, descents, ascents. Whoa. And down we go. Now this is where I have a feeling this truck could very well come unstuck. But we're going to give it a red hot go. Now, I have a feeling that this Range Rover is just not as capable as the Patrol. I don't know why. It just feels like because maybe it's wider and shorter wheelbase or something. I don't know. lifting a wheel. It's like fighting for grip. Now I'm hoping it doesn't tip over and end up in the creek. Oh. A little awkward here. Yeah, how's this Range Rover? Isn't doing too bad, actually. It's a little, little wide, pudgy. But as we come around onto the back end of the course, it's done just over halfway without any troubles. This is where we'll really get to test it. Come across for our deep water river crossing on the back end of the course. Let's see how it goes. Okay, well done to the Range Rover. No damage. And let's see how much fuel it used on that short trip. Oh dear. Oh, come on. We finished the course and now we can't get to the back of the petrol station? Really? And we're back with a total of 8 litres used. Okay, let's go grab one of the others and let's bring them onto the test course as well. Righto, next up on the test course will be Spun in Darkness's Camel Trophy Defender 110. Same thing applies again, we'll go fill it up with some fuel. And we'll test the fuel economy on this run. So once again, we're looking for damage, we're looking for how far it can get. Now the interesting thing with this one is we get permanent all-wheel drive and only got a dip lock as an option. So let's see how it does when we turn it into the course. In we go. Lock the dip and let's keep moving. See, this thing moves a lot quicker through the mud than the Range Rover did. With the military spec tires. It's a lot more capable in the wet stuff. And we're already up and out. Now, I know what you guys are thinking. Poor Discovery's gonna have to go through the worst tube trail ever. But I have a feeling it's not gonna do too bad. Now this is a little top heavy. Here we go. Whoa. Now some of you are wondering, why didn't you bring in Shark 777's Range Rover Sport? The reason why is because I think it's a little outclassed amongst these three. And someone said to me, oh, there's a modified Discovery. Yeah, I saw that one and I thought it didn't look that good. It looked like a bit of a cross-country special. Whereas these are really well detailed and nicely done. So I suppose you could say this is the scale Range Rover trail truck test. Oh boy. Don't slide down the hill, that would be bad. Because it's top heavy, it's keep pushing me to one side and I'm hoping it doesn't end up in the creek. Which is so easy to do. Oh, she's pushing it wide, I don't want it to. Oh, that would be bad for this thing if that happened. It's really hard to keep this thing from falling into the creek. So that top heavy gear does have an impact on it. Don't want to tip it. This feels a lot better to drive through mud than Hazard's Range Rover on the military spec tires. I know, well done Range Rover, well done Land Rover Defender 110, Camel Trophy Edition. Feels very sure-footed. So let's see what your fuel economy was for that trip. Same thing again, we drop it right into the deep mud. Oh, that's getting deep. It's getting real deep. Alrighty, fuel economy for the Range Rover. 5 litres. Wow, it's ahead. So that's the score to beat so far is 5 litres. Okay, let's get her up and out back to the garage and we'll bring on the last contender for our Range Rover shootout, which will be Fees's Discovery 3. Now, fully decked out on 38s. So let's change over. Grab that Discovery 3, fire it up, and let's go. Once again, same thing again, we don't get an option for the 4-wheel drive, 2-wheel drive, we only get an option for the diff lock. So once again, let's fill her up. Good. Let's take the Discovery into the test course, and then we'll test its fuel economy. So in we go. Oh, got damaged already. That's not good. Diff lock is engaged. Oh, this one's already losing on the damage alone. Got 5 points of damage already, but it is pulling through the water pretty strongly. So unless this thing gets like 3 litres of fuel consumption, it's going to be relegated to last place. Just on that damage alone, unfortunately. Oh boy. Now, whilst it has to deal with a more chewed up track, oh, it's just that water damage that's letting it down. Oh, lifting a wheel. Lifting another wheel. This one feels very different to the other two. Where are the... Both the Range Rover and the... Both the Range Rover and the Defender felt very sure-footed and very stable. This one's a little bit, I don't know how to say it, it's a little bit body rolly. Now, I haven't got the suspension jacked up or anything like that. I've got it on the standard setting, I haven't raised it. But it still feels a little bit body rolly. I can actually feel the body. Oh dear. I want to put it in the creek. At the same time, it bounced so far over. That body roll is causing me a few problems. It's still a very capable vehicle. It's just with the extra weight on the top, you can actually sense the body roll. I don't want to put it in the drink now, because that would be pretty bad to get all this way. A very capable vehicle, very capable. It's just that low water the low water intake on it is harming it. Again, here we go. Boy, that's getting deep. Just the way we like it. Righto, and the fuel economy figure for the Discovery 3 was 9 litres. Oh wow, that definitely seals it in last place. 9 litres. Okay, next up, we're going to take them to the Swamp Donkey map, and we are going to test them out on the rocks. So stay tuned as we go from the Mojave Green map to Swamp Donkey. Okay guys, we're at the Swamp Donkey map. What we'll do now is we'll once again load everything we can onto the Discovery and let's go take it up into the rocks. So since this was the bottom place position in the last test we did, it'll be the first one to go this time. I'm not going to grab the extra fuel, because that will probably lead to an unfair weight advantage. Now, I am not going to guarantee that this thing is going to get anywhere near as good on the rocks as it did in the last test. Because none of these vehicles are actually rock crawlers, but if we're going to do a shootout, we may as well see who knows how to do things best. So once again, We're looking for damage, and we're looking for distance on the rocks. So, first time to bottom it out will be where it'll stop. Now, bottoming it out means not using the winch. Now, we will use the winch for this first part, because not many trucks can get up here at all without using it. So we'll just see how the main road goes. Bounce. Not bad. Look at that. I'm still lifting the wheel. And it is finding grip. I don't know how, and I don't know where, but it is. Oh, we nearly had it. I think if we could just get our little rear end up this way, we'll be right. Oh, look at that. It's finding grip. Don't know how, but it is. Now, okay, just to make sure, let's raise the suspension up to make sure we're not ripping this truck off. Oh, that's dropping it. That's maximum raised height. Okay, let's see how we go now. Oh, looks like we're gonna have to call it there. She just can't. Oh, what? Wait, wait, wait. Oh, wow. Now, how's that for a surprise? Managed to crawl its way up this far without the use of a winch. That's moderately impressive. In fact, that's really impressive. See how far you can go without the use of a winch, huh? Well, I thought it might have got caught there, but no. She's still going. Wow-wee, no use of a winch. We've gotten this far. This is seriously impressing me. Man, it just changed gears. Well done, Range Rover Discovery by Fees. Well done indeed. Your hidden surprise on the rocks. Bastard hit there. Oh, that's a big hit. Worse for wear, but still, we're still going. Holy macaroni! I don't believe this truck. For something that looked like it couldn't do very much. Oh, I high-centered it, I think. Nope, we're still going. Jeez. Wow. Okay, we are really racking up damage. Still, look at this. Oop. It's starting to cause it some pain now. Oh, and I've... Ooh, no. But I think I've got it to a point where it's not going to recover. Alrighty, guys, we're going to call it there for the Range Rover, so let's check that distance out. All the way back to our little tree over here, as always. 449 metres. Wow. 449 for the Discovery 3. Are you as amazed as I am at just how far that thing went? I am. So, alright, let's park her up and we'll get the next truck out. Alrighty, wow, that was impressive. Okay, let's grab the Range Rover by Hazard and we'll change to the military spec tires. Because if they fitted it as an option, they should be better than default. So let's go see how the Range Rover does on the rocks. Fuel it up. And let's go. Now, judging by the size of these tyres, I'm going to imagine these aren't going to be very good on the rocks. But we'll see. If it's an option, it should be better than the default. It just looks a little weird. Okay, up and over. That nearly went off the track. Okay, let's go up and over. And up and over. Alright, same thing again. We're just going to hit it at speed and see how she goes. And up we go. Leading me not to where I'd like to go. But it seems to be having no issues climbing on the rocks at all. Got a little damage, but not bad. Come on, come on. You can get off this. Okay, maybe you can't. I'm trying. Yeah, it's not looking good for the Range Rover. It did really well on that first section. And now it's, struggling. I can see why. I think I bottomed it out. Maybe a different line. Will that help it? Oh, come on, rocket. See, this is where I think that raised suspension in the Discovery 3 gave it that little bit of an edge. Whereas now, the Range Rover is stuck spinning. I can try a different line, but I don't think it's going to be of any use. Alrighty guys, I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to call it there for the Range Rover. Total 308. Now, you're going to ask me, why are you using that little rock? If I measure it back to the garage, then basically what happens is it resets everything and you lose all the data. So that's why we use that little rock. So that's the Range Rover done. Let's get the Defender 110 out. Same thing again. Oh, actually, we should probably recover the Range Rover, shouldn't we? Let's recover it. Okay, drive it off. Out of the garage area and park it up. So, on the rocks, good old Discovery 3 outdid the Range Rover. Now let's see what the Camel Trophy truck can do. Once again, load it up. The only thing we won't do though is top up the fuel. Like the roof extra fuel. Okay, she's fueled up, let's go. Yep. And go far. Bouncy, bouncy. Go. I haven't even locked the dip in yet. I'm about to. So once again, we'll hit that first section of rock at speed, and we'll just see how the Range Rover goes. Will it get stuck in the same... Oh, sorry, the Defender goes. Will it get stuck in the same spot as the Range Rover, or will it get stuck before it? Straight up and in. Same thing again, it's trying to push me away from where I'd like it to go. Oh, come on, come on, you can get there. Come on. Yes, that's right. Oh, just walks over it. Look at that. Walks over where the Range Rover got hooked up. Bounce. Ooh. I mean, that hasn't caused us to get... Ooh, no, we're right. We're still moving. Ow. Bear in mind, this has 200 points less than the Discovery, and 400 points less than the Range Rover. How it did it, but it did it. No! Oh, no! Oh, this is unfair, really. It was going so well. But I placented it. I don't know how, but I have. Yeah, maybe its wheelbase is a little bit longer than the Discovery, and yeah, I placented it. Well, we'll have to call it right there. 389. Okay. Well, as you can see, guys, on the rocks, the Discovery 3 has the advantage. That ability to lift that suspension is given at the edge on the rocks. Alrighty, guys. Let's beam this poor thing back to the garage. And as always, guys, you decide who's the winner out of all them. Whether it is Spun in Darkness' Camel Trophy Defender 110, Feezer's Discovery 3, or Hazard's Range Rover on the military spec tyres. Alrighty guys, until next time, I'll say bye for now. Okay, bye for now. You guys decide the winner. That's all I can say. Bye for now.